Hello, Max the Beginning Man, here, welcome to part 7 of my redo trial Pokemon Ultra Moon, Randomizer Nuzlocke for the Nintendo 3DS. If you saw in the last part, we were to play a grand trial here in Colorado with Olivia at the Rules of Life. We lose any Pokemon yet again. So we're heading towards the next island, which I believe is the Ulu Island, to take on Mahokalani's travel stop, because this will be our 5th trial. Let's do a quick team recap. Oh, I'm looking at my bag. That's the wrong bag. That's the wrong thing. That's what we're looking at. So Fog of the Fog at deal level 35 with Steamy Rotary, Water Pulse, Bubble, and Quick Attack. Then Esper Escalade at deal level 34 with Bug Buzz, Magnet Bomb, Headbutt, and Twineo. Then we have George and the Gogo level 34, Tackle Rigidly, Vine with the Seed Bomb. Then Helen and Healer Optile level 34 with Power, Torch, Thunder Shock, and Quick Attack. Then Magnus and Storm and Magmore level 35 with Flame Burst, Fan Attack, Ember, and Fire Punch. And finally, Manny, the Manny Mega Meta Chat level 34 with Mist Ball, Rolling Kick, Faint, and False Form. This is level 34. It will be going to be our starter Magnus. Let's put him in the farm. We're going to continue on Maniac. Let's get we have to head, I think, to a couple places. So before, we're going to head to Ace of Paris, which we're going to be heading to next. Hope everyone's having a nice Friday. Having a nice good day. I think I should catch Shiny Snowball in Pokemon Go today. It's my third one overall, so, but I was already have a Grandma Dude, so I bet I can get Shiny Snowball's research, so. I got lucky, I'll take the extra as many as I can. Where's Coney Coney City? It should be up here. There we go, that's where I need to go. Let me heal the team. I'm gonna go to the restaurant and get a special Z set to get some hard skills. The restaurant's right here. Yeah. I'll take the special one. There's Olivia. Gonna join us for dinner. Take 4 heart scales, nice. I'll take it out of here. Now we're glad to hear her, you know. Is down here. Oh, Tom sticker, let me grab that. We got a Ruga to change his lander, his thunder was playing his form. Okay, cool. I don't think I have acrobatics as a team. Let me just check to make sure. So we go to where I was doing a couple of side quests over here. I know I don't have acrobatics as a TM. Nope, I do not. I don't think I have a Cobra Berry either. I don't. That's fine. That we can call this good. Let's go back to Halloween for a second. Let's try to go back to Halloween for a second. I can fly there because it's near the Pokemon Center. It's near by the Marina, so let's go to fly there for Cobra Club. Yeah, it's actually right here. I said a hypnosis one. Oh, battle it. Ah, pet Lil. We just ember this thing. We're madness. I'll take a bit now, that's good money seller. Alright, let's get out of here. Let me shut them off for a second. Okay, nothing going on in the mall. I'll go back to her hair now. Let's go to the beach area. I believe it's over here. Range cannon bonuses and its status condition. Yes, Alan, so we can find some hit, try to find some hit items. Sorry, where's the special attack? No one has a little special attack as, Paladin, if I'm not mistaken. 157, 72, 53, 99, 69. Oh, special defense. Oh my god, there's a special defense anyway, so that's even better. Cassie Berry. Thank you. gonna cover fossil. Alright, we find a signal more, bro. Like, we did it in alt mode. That's the first one. That's the second one right there. Third one there. That's the first one. Where's the sixth one? There it is. I got 20,000 Poké, I'll take that. Alright, let me look for those two fight scales. Portal Summoner, so we'll randomize items. A lychee berry. What are you gonna count here surfing? And some white glasses. Oh, the phone sticker right under the Santa gas there. There's another phone sticker here. There's the other one right there. We got a big poet who's gonna be a good money seller. Carl. Okay. Now we get battle the trains under in the route here. In the beach. What she's got. Yeah, Mega, that's perfect. Go for a flame burst here. Hit her a couple of attacks, that's okay. There we go. Get to level 35. Very nice. Okay, S is gonna run fight next. A blue suit, not bad. Pebble up. Okay, we're gonna stay for the pebble up. We're not gonna stop for the pebble up. Come on, tornado here. Luck out. Okay. Actually, we're for super effective move. Gengar. Let me get you out of there. Who do I have for Gengar? I gotta look you guys to the next one. Ooh, sorry. What do I meta if she's a ghost type? I wanna stay for now. She's with the ghost, so I'm gonna use it. Oh, Curse is gonna have a little bit more. She's gonna hurt herself for a curse on us. This is pretty much what we're gonna go. This is level 35. Okay, a little curse damage, that's alright. We'll try to get rid of that curse. Can I just block dragon? I'm gonna have to go to... I'll go to Medi. She has a fighting type. Let's go for a force bomb here. Nice. Throw level 35. Where's the special attack? Physical attacks, I mean. What you got? First one we have is an Envy Palm. I think I put Medi in the front. Oh, I put Helen. Let me get Helen out of there. Still looking for a stone, so I can evolve it to a Heliolisk. We'll go to Medi here, hit it with Moss Bomb. I'll still lower my attack and defense, that's fine. My one stage use. I'm gonna knock on it either way. I'll switch up, I'm gonna switch up. I'm not gonna switch up on this though. I'll go for a rolling kick. There you go. Can I level 35? Hold off now, even though it's a nice ground type move for you. Commander's gonna go on front next. Oh, shoot. There we go. Scatterbug. I was about to say, I'm not a switch up for a Scatterbug. I'll go for a Mistball here. Nice. And I got about, well, one more train out north and then we're good. Still the other counter, I don't have a counter yet. We're gonna do a turf run, plus we're not gonna use any of the water spots or anything like the other sand spots. Let's go for a surf, straight surfing encounter. Let's see what Alicia has. She has a charger bug. Okay, it's electric bug. This has a weak to bug. The only I can really go to is going to Madness, so we're gonna send him out. We'll go for a Flame Burst here. Charger fine. Very nice. That's also level 35. Okay, fall on the front. Next one becomes a good ninja, I can't wait for that. I wanna keep surfing. Don't wanna keep so close to the spot because you can get encounter. We're gonna go back and forth so we get an encounter. I know I didn't use the repel either, so. There we go. Oh, Meloetta, this is the regular form. I don't definitely have a count today. I don't know, it's level 23. I'll try a quick ball, sure. And then we're gonna weaken if we don't, if that doesn't work. No, didn't think so. I see that so it confused me, okay. I'll just go for, don't wanna hit this thing too much. I'm gonna bubble it. Let's see if we get the bubble off. We do it nice. I don't fuck all motors, so confusion's fine. Okay, for attack. If we get another bubble off, we don't. Okay, so we need to heal. Just a little potion, heal up. I'll see him, it's good. I don't want things to hit. So same confusion, quick attack, and tear dance is a moveset. We land on the bubble, good. Okay, that's good enough. Now I'm gonna put us to sleep, okay. What balls do I have? I call it Dream Ball. One, two, oh my, so close. I just go to the regular Great Ball. One, 2. Ah, almost. Kill the great ball. 1. No. Some confusion. That's very nice, please. One, two, oh no. One, two, let me heal. I do legendary, so I'm not surprised to fight the catch. It's not hard to fight the catch. I just heal. One. One. Two. Three. Did I get him this time? Ah, so close. I can heal again. One. One, two, 3? Did I catch it this time? Ah, so close. One. One. Let me heal. One, two, three. Did I catch it this time? Got it, nice. Took me a long time, but I got that. Part of Melody. You were MVP in my last Nuzlocke too, actually. I never really used it for the most part, too. Part of Melody. Oh, I'll definitely take that star piece. Let me grab this little pal. I'm using this little pal. Let me hit a sleep condition. I did have a rage candy ball to hit a sleep condition. I use a blue flute actually. There you go. Alright, I'm prepared for this go up. Now you get a post that's up there. Are we going to see what this Pokemon wear in the two spots? Then grab the item. Let's see what that first one is. Oh! Actually, I have Pikachu. Alright, I think someone's down in the Pokédex, if I'm mistaken. We'll run away from this thing. Alright, let's see what the second one is. Is it the same one? It is a horsey. That's not bad. Let's get out of here. Now we can get out of the beach. So make sure we don't touch those spots. Yeah, we're good. Oh, we're good. Oh. The Pikachu. Oh, before I do that. Yeah, dude, I thought I watched a wedding. Oh, it's Pikachu's. This is male too because of the difference of the tails. The left one's the male and the right one's the female. Mm-hmm. Got the rose incense. I think Gogar has a move ready for that. Georgia has a move. Has the item for. Let me just take a look at her for a second. Yeah, Shuri has a Rose Incense, so I can sell that second Rose Incense. Galvantula. Good job, that's sure we saw electric. Electric time. Let's see what we'll go down though. I thought it would have flame burst. We'll have to heal after this battle, but we should be fine. Nice enough. Probably be a good ninja now. I just do a dodge type. I gotta see my name dodge TM. Very nice, now I got Greninja into the team. Actually, you're getting Water Shuriken. This one's best. Oh, it goes first. That's good to know. I'll give it a bubble for it. That's pretty good. That's a tennis move too. I'll definitely give you Water Shuriken. Very nice. Okay. We're good, nice. Got a good Greninja on the team. Got the PK MZ. Pikachu. Pikachu. I'm gonna head inside the resort now. Let me just super potion up Linus. Alright, let's go inside. Okay. I'm not going there yet. Not yet tomorrow. I wanted to do some. We're gonna explore around the area here first. I was supposed to switch my team around before I did this, but we're okay. One has a Zekito, the other one has a Milotic. The Zekito is not Alolan. Let's see what I have. I have Magnus in the front. What about Magnus because it's weak to water? Let me see. I guess I'll Georgia for it, but I have nothing. I have to send my both grass types. Hey, who can I send out to hit this two battles here? Well, Esther could be one, because we... I thought Maddie and Esther. No, actually... Look, yeah, I thought Esther and Georgia, that's what I was sending out. Yeah, so we should have those two. That's fine. I kept those special, let's just push out to, Oh, but watch is fine. There's too many out. Many, I'm gonna go to Georgia. I'm gonna have Esther Twin Needle the Executor. That's fine. One shot, because unfortunately I went to bug. That's level 36 at least. Level 2? Absolutely. We're gonna get rid of Ember. That was Dragon Trap, I believe, yeah. Now I got kicked out. Okay. Fire come out. So we're just coming back out. But there's a... There's tornado on the Magnolic. Oh, I'm gonna have a switcher, yeah. I'm gonna connect a couple of hits on him. Back home, I'm gonna kick in. I'm gonna seed bomb the Nuzlocke, and I'm gonna have Esther heal. We should not have the my Nuzlocke. Slam, okay, nice. I just got Esther to the front. What do you got? Final call. Okay, best. I'm gonna switch off for a final call. I'll just go for a magna bomb. This is neutral damage. That's fine, that's fine. Not doing that much. Gone. That's a level 36. Okay, that's fine. Let me give Jordan the grass TMZ for now. Just for now, because I want to, it's for the next part. That's a dance with the crab baller. Oh, he's nervous. Headshot. I was gonna use this Z-move anyway just to be safe. And I'm gonna switch out immediately. I'll just go for Z-Bloom-Doom. There you go. Alright, you come out immediately. I'll set up Heller for this one. I'll hit it with a power balance charge. Get the health back. Let's get all our health back. We did. Very nice. Oh, 5 heals? I'll take that. I'll take 4 heals. Alright, let me get back. Let me give him the roll intent again. Let's go, now we go to Aether Paradise. I thought it's a paradise. There goes the Soda Woodle.
I'm So in here we have the three collector boxes for shiny. There are six total boxes in all here. Three Dragapult and three Crobat boxes. I just got a pair of scissors for the top of it. Thank you, buddy. Bye. Thank you, though. I really appreciate you trying to help. So, yes, there are three of them in each of these. This is an entire case of Dragapult and Crobat boxes. Oh, that's wild. I don't know if the microphone picked that up, but if it did, I'm sorry. All right, Dragapult.
So is it Duplana?
There we go. Empty box.
Deep.
Alright. We have three big fat boxes, three blue dragon boxes in total. So, there are seven. There are seven packs of these two boxes. So, in total, we have 14 packs. Hopefully, we get the cards we're looking for. At this point, we've got just about everything that I wanted to get. For Skyla, those are the two cards that are
left. It's going quite a lot. Before we lose them, that's the place we have to go for. Let me go back to the entrance for a minute. Get to pick up an item. That's what made Lucy mean.
Yeah, I'll write you out here. She's like, what am I going to do now? No, you didn't do it. You were mean. My bad. Okay, well, let's go ahead and get these all open up here. We take a look at these in the past. We'll just take a quick look at the promos and the cards and stuff. We're only going to do it on one of each of the boxes, so you get an idea of what we have. It's just commons and uncommons. It's fine. So, there is your Dragapult V and V Max cards. These are Sword and Shield promos number 96 and 97. Very cool looking Dragapult shiny. Very, very awesome. There's your coin. Upside down, jumbo Dragapult coin. I'm going to leave it here. I'll pick it out later. And then the jumbo promo is here as well. And the 7 pack of shiny tapes. So, now we just get to sit here and do this over and over again until we open up all six boxes. Technically three because it's three. But next up is the Crobat V box. There is the shiny Crobat V, which is the same as the one that's in this set.
Which one was about to open up?
Very playable Crobat V. V Max, not so much, but still cool. Pink Bat, Yellow Bat, Crobat Coin, and then also V Max. And we will commence with more than a booster box of shiny fates. 42 total packs in all. A lot of shiny fates. I do have intentions, by the way, of doing every product video for shiny fates. I have every single product that has come out for shiny fates sitting over there. I just want to wait
for battle it. It's not going to be another haggle, it's going to be something else. Oh, it's another Mega Medicham. That's going to raise the speed. I'll keep Georgia in. I don't really have a counter for him. I'll do a bug type. Yeah, I'll send out, let me bring out Esper. Yeah. I can go for a couple of twin needles here. Might we gotta be careful that can hit any move. It can hit any or any move. Oh come on, do we have a special attack on the fine, that's okay. Go for another twin needle here. Finish this thing off. My mind again, it's fine. We'll get the knockout here for sure. Go to level 36. That's the Ultra Recon Squad.
Sometimes it just gets to be a little bit much. Yeah. Alright, next up, we have Delmize. I mean, at least the amount of anchors that we've received have dropped off a little bit in the Delmize, because we started out getting so many Delmize that it wasn't even fun. But they kind of backed down quite a bit. There's our first shiny, and that is a huge shiny. Kind of a neat looking shiny there as well.
Jacko, thanks for
the 10 bits. Oh, we're upside down, Grammar and Polygon and Dark Drake. Those packs, those cards in
this pack,
seriously upside down.
Read it a second.
All right,
Grobot,
challenge accepted.
What did it say? It said he wanted anything. No, read it again. If you want, read it again. No, that's all you sent me.
What was the first answer?
Tell me I'm gonna pick up a layer, so you didn't want anything.
I told him that these were last time. Now I get mad, now they get, I get screamed up because, oh, you didn't do anything. Huh? Mm-hmm. You can't read messages? She don't have dancing fingers, that's why, joking off.
Why do you have to be like that?
Is it true?
Here. Nice, Matt. I got Ice Beam as a TM.
Since I already have the shiny and I have the
Now I'm gonna throw Ula
Island. The Rainbow V-Max, it would only accept now to have the shiny V-Max. Which just came by and bumped the hammer and turned it around.
Hello, Rock. Can I turn off that? I don't want to see that.
Regular rare.
Hey, where'd you go?
Find out some ADs, once we put some runs on the board. Alright, Evo, be back, here we go.
Judging the tournament. Thomas, if the league, if the tournament organizer was camp, then judge, it is me. So I get a match for doing this, yeah. That's my payment. Today. I'm gonna go! The last tournament we did, the last one. Well, this one's still only another match. That's what we have to do. But he threw a box for himself again. Hold on. Let me check some more. It's fine. There's no problem. Hold on. Yeah, I mean, dinner early when starting. Yeah. I love you. You need- Juju? I do what? That's not fair. I love you.
What?
How was that? My baby. So sorry, my god. Sorry, you. Do it. You deserve it. Why? How much you put? Give us. Okay, Lon.
I forgot, I'm sorry.
You read the message once.
Yeah.
He wrote the message wrong, I thought I was only asking him.
That's fine.
Don't pull my stuff, that's not for you.
Columbium? I'll take the medium right there, you guys. Right? What do you usually get?
I got there for lunch time. It's Jesus Christ, Mom. I texted, when I was in the next room,
Kaylee's gonna be a real chicken.
Okay, she asked Mom if she wanted it. She said no, she was one himself.
Yeah. We'll buy some beans here.
That song is called Mom Straight. What's the word I want to use for? He's in love with the spirit. Right, Josh? Okay, Josh, right? That's your...
You want drugs.
Wait, it is, look, you didn't get off yet.
Yeah,
I get off it. Josh,
you power.
He's totally Chinese.
Asama's wife in Filipino.
He's white. He's got issues. Yeah, I have to go to the doctor for her. You can call me on Wednesday. How you want it?
The doctor. 718.
I know you were mom.
It's
6:20. Yeah, I should be drinking. You're right, though.
Quiero una pechuga a la plancha con
pero
como
no.
Le ponga las
papitas
y la papa
frita que está separada. Oh, bomb. Oh, what a catch.
Una bandeja con carne asada.
Oh my god, can you sit down on your table?
Sí. Esto nada.
Makes sense.
Y le puedo apagar.
Y le puedo
pagar
en
tarjeta, ¿no?
Oh, gracias. Yeah, I agree.
$50.
Damn. Fine. What did you buy for a
ton of $50? It's $56.
I have cash.
I'll give you $50.
Oh, okay. You already offered too much.
You have cash?
$1. Not for $50.
You greedy.
Are you up?
No. You went this morning. I saw you bring a grilled chicken.
I forgot. That my
How are you gonna forget? He went just to get that.
I forgot text messages.
You don't read text, so you're an idiot.
I can.
Oh no! No! You guys know I'm a fan. Absolutely not. No.
He probably didn't read it, but you are more specific.
He has no understanding. Sorry.
You asked. Yes.
La 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 la.
I'm just gonna forget.
You call me to your doctor. You call me to your doctor on Wednesday.
Okay. Let's go.
Yeah.
Oh, he already did. He took some food already.
Yeah, I did. That's fine. Yeah, that's fine.
What did he say? I'm gonna take the gadget. Take the computer for that.
Okay.
Wait, if you ever get to the same place as White Stone? Yeah. Work out at 9 a.m. bitch. What's that on? Oh, I don't think I should. I'm not going to. I have a picture. Hold on. I'm looking for it. No. Okay. I got tested. I'm negative, guys. No COVID in Utah. Here, Mom. Yeah, exactly. That's the only one that matters. Mom. She bought a frame like that. And she did that.
How was it?
Not helpful.
I have to do this.
What? I have to do what? Bossy.
I have to do it. See, I have like this.
The pregnancy, yeah. But how are you going to do that? Is that surgery? You going to do the surgery?
Oh,
yeah, you have to. Yeah. You have to go to Colombia, Zilla.
I can't do it here.
You can do it here, but like it's just $7,000. Here, just let me get it from the baby.
Yes, you will pay for it.
100%. That's mom's forever gift. That's the only gift like ever again. Yeah. It's like cool that the paper is crazy.
You have to have both. You have to think.
You have a lot of babies, so you should wear a computer all the time.
Maybe next year, maybe in a couple of years, I'm going to have a house.
Here or there? Or there? Oh yeah, of course, yeah. We're working on that. We're working on that. Oh.
It's
gonna be forever.
You gotta have ambition.
It's gonna be forever.
Ambition.
Philippines, here I come. Couple years. We know it, like permanently. I'm thinking you're right. I'm not sure. Told you, it's the first time you've experienced. It's okay.
20 hours of plane. I don't.
That's fine. I'm sleeping. Mom's like, you can't do 18 hours on a plane. You can barely do 5.
I passed it since 92.
That one? The one you took? Yeah, you did it once already.
92.
What did you get wrong? Obviously, you got wrong. No, now you still have 50. One of them. I know I'm after.
I gotta get 100
couple of times. You know that? Me? I know. No, value? Huh? What? You want me to do a snip snip? It's not happening. Value? There's no before, baby. It's one timer, that's it. The vasectomy video we lost? Oh, the circumcis- Oh, too late, I'm sure. Too long upstairs. I think it's about so like. Excuse me. Ooh, milkfish. I don't know. Let me ask mom. Hold on, I'll be right back. Hold on. Mom!
Are we
When we were babies. Mm-hmm. I'm not gonna ask any how you know that, but okay, sure. Yeah, but I thought she asked me why you asked that question. That's disgusting, but if she like I told her because in the Philippines it's like mandatory. When you're a boy, right? It's like mandatory? No, I told her. I reassured her that. Don't worry. Yeah. I reassured her that in the Philippines is mandatory. Like, they have to do it. Yeah, don't worry. You're fine. Mm-hmm. You're okay. You're fine. Why are you laughing? I'm not laughing.
We're alive on the farm, it's time to live back. Ain't much an old country boy if you can't even act. So that you rise early in the sack.
Why are you laughing?
Thank God I'm a country boy. We're a simple kind of life, baby, did me no harm. Thank God I'm a country boy.
Hey everyone, it's Mark Weems. I am in Quezon City, which is right next to Manila in the Philippines. And I'm at a restaurant today for lunch, which is called Pochok Pangrisan. And this is a restaurant, this is a carinderia, which is a local food house eatery. It's a family-run restaurant, it's a friendly place to eat, and they serve some amazing-looking Filipino food here. And especially one of their main dishes is the bangus, which is a milkfish. And it looks absolutely stunning. This is adobo? Okay.
Ooh, adobo. Oh my god. Ooh.
kick. What is this on top?
Along
with a huge selection of local Filipino food that you can pick and choose from, one of the things that you have to order when you eat at Pochok Bangusan is their special bangus. Bangus, which is a milk fish, is grilled on an insanely hot fire, and the charcoal is even fanned to keep it flaming hot. After the milk fish is grilled, it's flipped over, and to finish it off, it's topped in a thick layer of green tomato relish. It's an absolute stunner of a dish that you don't want to miss.
Pochok Bangusan. Oh, Pochok.
What? Like what? Oh.
Pochok Bangusan. Okay, thank you. This local restaurant is in Quezon City, so it's a little drive from central, from the downtown area of Manila, but it looks like the food is going to be well worth it. I think it's about 11 a.m. right now, so most of the dishes are freshly prepared for lunch. This is one of the best times to come eat here, and the food looks cold. Yeah, the dishes are full too, so I think they're about to get a big lunch rush, but we got here before the rush.
Sorry. The house, you know how I don't know how Korea does it. Like Korea? What? I don't know. Is Timo Park still close? I don't see it. I got it now. Good morning, man. Oh my God. Babe, look what I found online we better watch.
For over 30 years, John Tapper has traveled the country saving hundreds of bars from failure and ruin. And he thought he'd seen it all until the COVID-19 pandemic hit.
Look, I've met terrible owners, unruly staff, out-of-control financing, but I've never seen anything like this.
And no business was hit harder than America's hospitality industry.
Thousands of bars have closed already, and more are going to close. America is built on small businesses, and I want to fight to keep as many bars open as I possibly can.
So now, John's not only rescuing struggling businesses, he's trying to save an entire industry, one bar at a time.
Failure is not an option. No excuses.
So this season, John's starting with the hospitality capital of the world and the place he calls home, Las Vegas.
This is now personal to me. I cannot let them down.
In 2018, veteran restaurant owner Ron Pellegrino bought his favorite local hangout, Paradise Cantina.
Years before I bought the place, I came in here as a regular. Everybody comes to the cantina at one point or another. Especially when people are like, oh, I've never done that. And then they walk in, they're like, oh yeah, I've been here before.
He immediately found success, taking in over $1.2 million in his first year of operation.
By 2019, now we did like $1.2 million in sales. I don't know if they ever did that. And it paid them.
Riding high on the success of 2019, 2020 started out very well for Ron and the Paradise Cantina staff.
We started 2020 on a high note. I mean, we started going in getting ready to have the best year we've ever had, and we had good things on the horizon.
However, when the COVID-19 pandemic hit Las Vegas, Ron's hope for a successful year quickly evaporated.
We're getting ready to expand, open up two more locations in the Vegas area. I mean, you talk about from a high to a low, you know, extremely quick.
Without question, Ron put the needs of the staff in the bar before himself.
Every time we shut down, the next day he was texting everybody, listen, we'll get through it. You got a job to come back to, I'll do whatever it takes to keep this place open and keep you guys employed.
This is the last 6 months of sales that.
And now, Ron is in over $750,000 of debt and lost his life savings.
I mean, so much debt, I don't even have a clue. I think I lost over $1 million this year on paper, but I don't even know. I'm literally actually homeless. I'm staying in a hotel right now, this last 6 weeks.
Ron's blind loyalty in protecting his staff has caused him to overlook what's going on behind the bar.
Yeah, if somebody wants to buy us a shot, something like that, yeah, we're allowed to do a shot.
We do a shot?
I don't think there's any way of keeping these guys in line.
Unable to handle the demise of the restaurant in the face of the pandemic, Ron's leadership has suffered.
I can actually see the stress on him. It's a rough situation. I can't imagine being in his shoes, trying to take care of all of us, trying to take care of all of the guests, and then still present that happiness.
It never was hard to do that for this year at all. It was easy. It was fun.
Having lost almost everything in a final attempt to save Paradise Cantina, Ron has agreed to pull back the doors, bust open the book to make a call for help to bar rescue.
Unfortunately, I need John Tapper to finish what I couldn't.
Chevy is America's fastest growing full-line brand, and people are taking it everywhere. Taking Trailblazer outdoors, confidently taking on new places with Equinox, and taking on more with Silverado. Whatever you do, there's a perfect Chevy to take you anywhere. Find your perfect Chevy this Memorial Day. Current qualified competitive lessees can get this 2021 Equinox for around $159 a month, or get up to 18% of MSRP cash back on select 2021 models when you purchase.
For the last 14 years, I've been New York City's go-to crisis manager. From pumping out water during Hurricane Sandy to delivering a million meals a day during the pandemic. When there's a crisis, sometimes you got to break glass to solve it.
At Charmin, we make paper, but we love trees. That's why we protect forests. By using pulp certified by the Forest Stewardship Council, it's why we regrow at least 2 trees for every tree we use. And it's why, when forests are devastated by natural disasters, Charmin helps restore trees through the Arbor Day Foundation. So you can enjoy the go, but forests remain forests. Charmin. Ever notice how stiff clothes can feel rough on your skin? It's because they rub against you, creating friction. And your clothes rub against you all day. For softer clothes that are gentle on your skin, try Downy's Free and Gentle. Just pour into the rinse dispenser, and Downy will soften your clothes without sides or perfume. The towel wash with Downy is softer, fluffier, and gentle on your skin. Try Downy's Free and Gentle. Recognized by the National Psoriasis Foundation and National Eczema Association. When our daughter and her kids moved in with us,
kids, bedtime,
she was worried we wouldn't be able to keep up.
Of course we can.
Well, couldn't keep up with our bargain detergent.
Turns out it's mostly water, and that doesn't work as well on stains.
So we switch back to Tide. One wash, same for them.
Kind of like our car touch.
Don't pay for water. Tide is concentrated with 3 times the active cleaning ingredients. If it's gotta be clean, it's gotta be Tide.
I'm going to a place called Paradise Cantina. It's a small bar in a strip mall just 1.5 miles east of the Las Vegas Strip and right next door to UNLV. This bar is really unique. It's a hot spot for hospitality workers from the casinos, college kids next door, and tourists looking for a party bar to drink before a night out on the town. It's also a place where the city's essential workers like to come when they get off their shifts. This bar is the quintessential local spot, and I need to find out if they're suffering because of the pandemic or because of the choices management made leading up to it.
See
for the bar, John brings in skilled mixologist Derek Turner. For the kitchen, John brings in Timmy Lambert, a 3-time James Beard nominee.
Here it is, Paradise Cantina. This bar is owned by a guy by the name of Ron. And Ron bought this bar 2 years ago, and after he bought it, he's lost 35% revenue. And now the pandemic is starting to open up a little, so there's a chance for this poor guy to make money and come out of this. The problem is he's blaming his failure on the pandemic, but his revenues were down 35% before the pandemic. So let's call him out on anything that we see. I don't want this guy to have a free ride and blame all of this on the pandemic. Okay, I'll see you in 3 seconds.
All right. John's experts enter Paradise Cantina, a 2,000 square foot space with a U-shaped bar and a pass-through window to a kitchen in the back.
This season, the stakes are higher than they've ever been. So I've asked my team to create an enhanced command center with video monitors and screens everywhere so I can see much more than I did in my SUV. I can't miss anything that might be the reason for their failure. Fact of the matter is, I have very little time and they don't have another chance. It's amazing. I can see more in here than I used to see inside.
Hey, gentlemen, how are we doing?
Good, good.
You guys doing stuff?
Yeah.
You guys want to sit in a booth or a couple of high towers?
I think it would be great. Yeah, I'll talk with you.
The blonde gentleman's a bartender. His name is Jake.
So, I apologize. It's Tapios. It's actually 2-for-1.
And he's one of Ron's best friends. The blonde female bartender's name is Melissa. She's been here for a couple of years. The male behind the bar with the darker hair, his name is Jared. He's a bartender. He's been here for a couple of years as well. Paco, the chef, has actually been here for well over 10 years. And the waitress's name is Aviva. She's been here for a couple of years as well, and she's now training to be a bartender.
Should we do a shot?
Hi guys, how are you?
Good, yourself?
Good. My name's Melissa.
Nice to meet you. Do you actually have, is the cocktail menu?
Paper menus? Every bar should be using QR codes during the pandemic.
We actually have our margaritas and our beer list here. It's all bottles and cans. We don't have any draft.
I'm filling a little paradise. How about a mojito?
Look, we can't make them. Yeah, because we don't have margaritas.
How about a Mai Tai?
Mai Tai? Yeah, we can do that. Yeah.
I'm looking for like maybe a watermelon margarita or something like that.
Yeah, the watermelon.
Fuck yeah. Huh?
Well, there you go.
Oh, we'll start off with that.
Alright. Can I have a little more strawberry because it's kind of strong.
Like a sweet?
No, like really strong with alcohol.
Oh, strong with alcohol. Oh, okay. Okay. Not a problem. Let me get this out of your way.
Jared, can you make me another strawberry? A little bit sweeter, less booze. Same thing, Ron, please.
Of course, less alcohol. There's your 35%, Ron.
That's the first.
Hold on.
What? That's the first. Is you said your drinks were too strong? That's not a first. That's not a first. So Ron knows it's a problem, yeah. And he's letting it happen.
How are we doing tonight, boys?
Good. Thank you.
You guys look good. You guys live in town?
Yeah, just in for a couple of days.
Oh, I'm sorry, bro.
I recognize you now that I'm sitting here. I was just saying hello.
You know what, guys? They got us made. I want you to order one of everything on the menu. Let's go for it.
Yeah. All right. Well, since our cover's blown, then let's see what you got. Give me one of everything on the menu. Send it out.
Very well.
Okay. And Derek, I think you should order several drinks.
All right.
Look at that command center.
Oh, no, perfect.
I actually have an order, quite a big order. Okay. So Matt, please have the Cantina Margarita.
Okay.
The Rochester Margarita. And Matt, please have the Skinny Margarita because it's supposed to be light.
All right.
Papito, is this a 54 right here?
Yeah.
Okay. For 54, put that together so we know then. Bro, literally, you don't build the table. It's one table that wants everything. So as it comes up, just yell 54 to them so I know, okay? Please and thank you.
We're ordering
one of everything, too. So I'm going to have to bring that in after.
Ooh. This supposed to be a margarita looking like a jalapeno. I just taste sour mix.
Yeah.
It tastes unbelievably sour. Like, not fresh, not good.
Behind
all
you is
right,
some carnitas
tacos.
Yeah.
Holy. Can you tell me what tacos look like? Because they all look
the same. This is an El Dorado margarita. This is a classic margarita. And I'm not sure what this is. Do they taste the same?
No, they taste terrible.
Okay.
Margaritas aren't too tasty, boys.
The biggest thing I'm seeing is like it's very highly inconsistent. There's no variation in cocktail and whatever cocktails you guys do that you have. It's not good.
Paradise rolls.
Oh, that guacamole, is that something you guys make?
Yeah, so it comes, we get a chunk of puree and then we add fresh avocado and pico de gallo into it.
So it's not homemade.
You see how it looks a little dark? It's just, you know, when I think of avocado,
yeah,
I think
it's bright.
There's no layers of flavor.
Like, some people are textured, some people are looks. I'm just, you know, I've seen everything I need to see. He's filled with excuses. I want to call him out and taste this food myself.
Uh-oh. He's going to talk to dog. Oh, hey.
I keep saying layers of flavor. It's just one note. But I'm missing the mark.
So let me throw a couple of things at you.
What?
When I look at things like this presentation, we've got to do better.
I'm with it.
We've got to do better. Our flavors are lacking. So here's what I want to do, guys. Why don't you finish up?
All right.
I want to go talk to Rob.
So you know Taffer's coming.
Mm-hmm.
Taffer sends his guys in, and that's the night that they f***ed it up? Come on, I don't buy that.
Yeah.
And if they blew it tonight on best behavior, you think it's better on other nights?
No.
You're running about
twice the cost that you should behind the bar.
Sure. Easy.
So is that your employees doing that?
Mm-hmm.
So well, you know they
drink.
You know they give away drinks. Yeah. They offer four drinks.
100%.
Now, this pandemic, you have busted your ass to keep them working, haven't you?
Yeah.
And you realize there are times that they're f***ing you.
Yep.
And I just want to be straight with you.
Yeah.
Sometimes as an owner, you treat them like family, but they're not. There is something that should greatly concern you about the way your bartending staff is functioning back then. I'm being straight with you. The numbers are what they are. If they love you like you think, and you stepped up for them, now's the time for them to step up for you. Fair?
100%.
So I want you to go in there, and I want you to tell them what I told you. That they're f***ing you.
They only do it because I allowed it to f***.
And there it is.
That's 100%
on you. Yeah. And you can't blame that.
No, and I'm not. I'm not.
Another 30% of profits would have gone a long way for you in bar costs, right?
30%.
Don't freaking tell them that now.
All right.
Fight for this, and I got your back, and I will see you tomorrow.
Jerry.
Yeah, buddy.
Come here.
When I started to talk to Ryan tonight, I find that the failure is due to management, waste, and bad training more than any pandemic.
Will you ring it up and comp the f***ing show?
I think so.
Well, now we f***ing know. We're going to clarify everything. Every f***ing thing gets rang up. Every single thing we do, whether we're comp or not. Every single f***ing thing. Because, like, literally going into the f***ing poor home to keep this shit all open. And then just sit there and be like, well, that's good. Because the same people you're doing that for are robbing f***ing blind.
For the last 14 years, I've been New York City's go-to crisis manager. From pumping out water during Hurricane Sandy to delivering a million meals a day during the pandemic. When there's a crisis, sometimes you got a great class to solve it.
I love you more.
No. Someone just got her period. What size do you need?
Wait, in 2005?
Yes. Your flow changes, and so should the size of your Tampax.
Hmm.
Only Tampax has 5 sizes. If it hurts to remove, go down. If it leaks,
go up. I'll take a regular for today, and for tomorrow, a super.
Nice. Tampax, the only tampon with a leak guard braid to help give you more leak-free periods. Time for Tampax? What's your combo?
Are you tired of clean clothes that just don't smell clean? What if your clothes could stay fresh for weeks? Now they can. Downy Unstoppable's in-wash scent boosters keep your laundry smelling fresh way longer than detergent alone. Pour a cap of Downy Unstoppable's into your washing machine before each load and enjoy fresher smelling laundry. With 6 times the freshness ingredients, Downy Unstoppable's gives you more of what you love. If you want laundry to smell fresh for weeks, make sure you have Downy Unstoppable's in-wash scent boosters.
Tide Pods Ultra Oxy one-ups the cleaning power of liquids.
Can it one-up spaghetti night?
It sure can.
Really?
Can it one-up breakfast for the best?
Yeah, for sure.
You can't have the one to do that?
What about that?
Can? Yeah, even that.
I would very much like to do that.
Me too.
Tide Pods Ultra Oxy. One of the toughest stains with 50% more cleaning power than liquid detergent. Any further questions? Nope. One of the power of liquid with Tide Pods Ultra Oxy.
It's an important time to save. With Priceline, you can get up to 60% off amazing hotels. And when you get a big deal, you feel like a big deal. Priceline. Every trip is a big deal.
What's going to happen is you're going to be the f***ing guy behind the bar the entire f***ing week that's going to be mindful of this. Every f***ing drop. Every drop gets rang up. And be mindful of your core. You know, dude, like literally going into the f***ing pool home to keep this shit all open and then just sit there and be like, well, that's good because the same people you're doing that for are robbing you f***ing blind. This shit ain't going to happen. You're number one on that. You keep your mind full. You say it to everybody. I will talk to you and everybody simply, straight up, one-on-one, okay? People giving shit away, this is f***ing gross considering I'm sitting, I'm going to go to a f***ing hotel room and put it on my credit card as a check back in somehow. And the only people that have been paying in this building for the last year are all the people that basically, the one thing we can at least admit is that the consistency was off. 100%. There's no denying that. Well, consistency one thing, and a shit ton of booze going down the drain that ain't getting rang up is a totally another thing too, right? You do realize that we're like, I'm at the end of it. This is the shit, right? Does everybody know that? Like, real life. I know I don't say it. I know I don't say it enough. I know I don't piss and moan about, you know, my finances and the canteen and everything. But I am actually homeless at the current moment. Does everybody know that I don't actually have a dwelling, a place to live, so I can keep this place open? This is the last shot. This is it. Alright, somebody, come on, clean this place. Let's help them out. It's a shithole.
I think what Ronnie said was accurate about consistency being all, but I definitely don't think we are failing. There should be a shift in priorities and what we take more seriously, but definitely not failure, though.
When I got here last night, Ron told me that this failure was due to the pandemic. Run around? He was just here. Today, I need him to understand that failure is due to him. His actions and the actions of his staff is what caused his failure. There he is. Mr. Staffer. How are we, buddy? How are we doing, sir? Good morning, Mr. Staffer. Now, nobody saw Gray coming in today. I could just see everybody's body language. I didn't feel good coming in today at all. I mean, I wasn't proud of what happened in here last night.
Thank you.
A little beat up, but I'm ready to rectify and turn the corner, sir.
How far are you behind the glen?
I got a little reprieve, to be very honest with you.
So you were facing an eviction? Are you close?
It was, well, I didn't have any more money to pay anything.
You surviving this Christmas?
I have no place of residence, that's for certain.
So you lost your home over this. So I want to show you something. Now, this was low sales because of this pandemic. I get it. But they poured, based on your drink price, was $3,600 worth of booze.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? They collected $1,800.
And this accounts for
50%.
That's right.
50% was given away. So when I look at this number, 1,800 lost, that was just the weekend. A month, 15,6, 187 a year.
Now, when you look at this, this is accounting for,
this is real.
For 1.5 hours, and I'm just accounting for a holiday?
Yes. So I want to show you what this means. So your beverage cost should be about 21%.
Yes.
Okay, so 21% of 785 is 165,000. That's what you should have spent on liquor. You spent 326. What would you have done with 100 grand this year that you didn't spend? Would you still have your liquor?
You know the answer to that question.
You do know the answer to that. You left this frickin' money on the table, and they gracefully gave it away. You didn't lose your home because of the pandemic. You lost your home because of you.
You know how brutal this is, Dennis? How much, like, working twice as hard this year to make for nothing?
Well, and then you need to understand that in the moment, they take care of themselves and their customer.
Mm-hmm.
And you.
Yeah.
And that has to change.
Okay, let's go talk to your staff.
Yeah.
It's difficult when you know you pride yourself on being an operator and being here daily and knowing what's going on.
Guys, can we all get together and talk for a couple minutes?
I'm ready to turn the page and move on, but last night was shit. So, turn around from that.
Good to meet you guys.
You know I live here, right?
This is my city, guys. I'm all about Las Vegas. I'm all about our industry. I'm all about this business. And I know that you guys were successful. You know, this was a great party bar. It's a great place where people would meet up, have a shot or two, a drink or two, then go off and party for the night, or meet here later during the night. But it was a stop in people's lifestyle, right? We came here 2-3 times a week, or every weekend, or every Friday, or every Saturday, and you saw the same faces all the time.
This is an important bar in this city. Employees come here, right? All the hospitality employees that make our visitors happy every day come here.
This is a bar that was rooted in the community, had a following, and was pretty darn successful. I want to share something with you. On Saturday night, we sold $1,800. That's the amount of revenue we took in. But we poured $3,600 worth of booze. We lost money Saturday night. You lost money Saturday night, but you made money, didn't you? What is your name?
My name is Gene.
And you're really good friends with Ronnie, right?
Yeah.
You guys are like best buds? Okay, so your best friend.
Yep.
What's your name?
I'm Jared.
How about you, Jared? Did you make money?
Yes, sir.
You lost money. You see, you guys are thinking that things are great because you leave with money in your pocket. But your actions behind the bar are causing his failure.
This past year, over pours, taking care of friends, maybe keeping a tip or two and applying it towards a sale, that $165,000 cost him his home.
Yep.
His home.
I love you.
Is that fair?
I'll be interested in it.
Ronnie, this is not a moment for pride. Had that not happened, would you still have your home now?
Nope. You will, yeah. You've got fun.
Yes, sir. So I want you to understand, he lost his house, he's borrowing money to survive, thinking it's the pandemic, but it's not. It's you guys. Had you done this right and be responsible in the alcohol, the money transactions, he wouldn't be having this problem right now. And when I talk to him, he talks about so proudly how he kept you guys working and how you mean so much to him and how he fought for you and you're his best friend. And you f***ed up.
Oui. Oui, 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 oui.
The Calming Scent of Lavender by Daniel and Susan Calm. Laundry isn't done until it's done with
laundry. JT tried Game Flames for the first time the other day. The scent made quite an impression. It was like Hal and JT were the only two left on Earth. But they weren't. You can always spot a first timer. Game Flames with Oxygen for free. Seriously, happy scent. Try the new light scent from Game. Hello, Brain Daydream.
Hey, you know how we're going to fully beat COVID? Yeah, by getting vaccinated. That's right. And in New York State, now everyone can.
Yeah, now anyone 12 or older can get an appointment, right?
And the vaccines are safe and effective and free.
And now we can get back to doing the things we love with the people we love. All right?
Right. You gotta protect yourself, your family,
and your community.
Do New York stuff. Spread the word.
You
can get vaccinated now.
I love you.
It's our block, our place, our people. Not having a ride to get the vaccine can't be the reason you don't get it.
Want to help? Donate a ride today.
Design isn't just for designers. It's for everyone. With Canva, designing anything is easy. Canva has all my content creation needs covered. It's flexible, fun to use, and free. There are thousands of professional templates to help get you started, so you can create, customize, and share your design in just a few clicks.
Our whole team uses Canva to create a professional market. That helps our secret weapon for design.
Start designing for free at canva.com.
And you can think of those moments when you had a choice of coming through for the house or coming through for you. And I'm going to suggest too often you guys came through for you.
Ronnie is my guy. He's a big brother. So when I hear these kind of numbers and stuff and the trouble that he's in, you know, it's heartbreaking.
When I look at the sales level in here, is what I'm saying unreasonable?
No, I'm just not sure if it's taking into consideration 2-for-1 happy hour in the comp on games.
It is. What's your name?
Melissa.
Has he ever said to you, watch your poor?
Nope.
I don't think
so. So if I were to say to you, why is it like this? I can look at this two ways. I can say, you did this. Or I can say,
and I allow it.
You with me? So my point is this, it's on you in the end. And you have to be able to, from the other side of the room, look at Melissa and have her know that you're watching her poor.
I think that Ronnie was kind of taken aback from something that he's done his whole life. We thought we were running great, and now we're being told we weren't.
We got to toughen him up, don't we? He has to enforce standards better, doesn't he?
Yep.
You guys agree?
Yep.
Now, pandemic is starting to wind down, isn't it?
Yeah.
People are getting vaccinated now. Things are starting to feel like they're going to go open up. We could have a great summer. So I got to set you up because you got a lot of money to catch up to. And if you feel they're not 100% behind you, are you willing to make changes?
John, listen, if this doesn't work, we're all out of a job, so.
You have no choice, do you?
No.
Okay, so
step up or step out. That's where we're at, isn't it? Okay, just want to make that clear to everybody. Okay, let's go to work, guys. What is up, guys? What's going on? So based on what I saw last night, I saw that there was no consistency in any of the cocktails. So tonight, what we want to do is focus on pouring, consistency, and just working as a unit all together to get these drinks out. Okay, so today we're going to be making a cocktail called the Tropical Sunset, okay? So 1 ounce of gold rum, 1 ounce of silver rum. All right, here's that. Not too much of one count, yeah? Lime, equal parts, or equal parts to our zest. And then we're going to ice this off. We're going to get a column glass, geranium, and orchid flower. Again, simple
easy. Wow, it looks beautiful. It looks absolutely amazing.
And it's color, right? It's pigmentation. People see it, they go, what's that? And boom, I want to order them. So, Jared, Melissa, I need you to get back there. We're going to do a head-to-head competition to see who's the best bartender.
All right. Yeah, let's go. Jared called Mel and I, and automatically I was like, don't screw this up.
3, 2, 1, let's go. Hey, Jared, it's running away from you, man. He's almost done.
I just had so much going on in my head that I wanted to be fast, and I shorted it.
So Jared was fast, but the problem is it was inconsistent. If you get this drink and you pay equal price for this, you're going to be a little mad. So, Melissa, you won this round.
What happens, we'll get it dialed in now with a little more training, and then get ready for the stress test tonight and rock and roll.
Tonight, we need to get those cocktails down packed. We need to be consistent, and we need to be making money. We have to crush it. So, let's do this.
Well, obviously, we were here last night. I had a chance to taste the food, and it fell short.
There's a lot of work to do. The food was flat. Everything had one note. So, in kitchen training today, I'm going to have to introduce layers of flavor.
You can go anywhere and just get a buffalo wing, right? So we're going to add some layers of flavor.
I'm going
to grab some wings here. We've got this jalapeno rind. Let that chicken sit in there, and you're adding flavor before it's even cooked. We're going to go right on the grill. Have this little teriyaki glaze. And as these cook, we just add a little bit. And we'll just keep basting it.
There you go.
Layering it with flavor. And we'll just kind of give a little bit of high to it. But then we're going to pop this off with this beautiful pineapple salsa. You can see the freshness on the plate, right? So it's a simple dish, but delicious.
I want to put
it in. The contrast is excellent. We carry chicken wings that are pretty popular, but this is something completely different than what we do. There were so many different layers for such a simple item. How quickly it was cooked is pretty impressive.
Tonight's stress test. Let's get excited. Let's put some passion into it. I'm ready.
All right, thank you, sir. Appreciate it. I want to get us all together for a minute before we open up. I want to focus tonight on speed and accuracy. I'm giving every customer a number of poker chips. When you guys sell a drink, I want you to drop the chip that the customer gives you in your bucket. This way we can see how many drinks you sold at the end of the night. We can see who's faster. Next, any time a drink isn't right, Derek is going to dump it in the bucket. At the end of the night, we're going to see who was the most accurate, and we're going to see who was the fastest. Friendly competition is always good, and it always makes you a little bit better. But I think going into the stress test tonight, I'm definitely nervous, stressful. The whole point of this is stress test, right? I want to stress this out. The COVID's not so easy. I can only put so many people in a room. So I'm having everybody order 2, 3, and 4 drinks.
No, let's go. I called that. Let's do it.
Now, I'll tell you why. Next month, 2 months from now, we better be ready.
That's what it's done.
Absolutely. Okay, let's set up and get ready.
Hey, guys, welcome to Paradise Cantina. Come on in. Let's go. Come on in. Hey, nice to see you again. How you doing? What's up, my friend? How we doing?
Hi, how are you guys doing today? Welcome to Paradise
Cantina.
Hi, welcome back.
All right. Shoot, I'm overdoing that.
You're not about to take that over and under.
All right, guys, let me get that in for you. I'll be right back, okay?
You're not going to have to take that, right?
What's that?
It's an overpour on the gold.
You guys are thirsty, right? Let's go. Let's get some energy here. It's supposed to be a party bar, right? Who's ordered that hasn't gotten a drink? So, guys, take more orders. People don't have orders.
I just got her order.
Okay, let's get them in and get back out there, guys. This is about speed. Let's go.
Oh,
boy.
All right, so we're falling in behind because of the wings. We're hanging in there. The wings, so a bunch of incomplete orders went out because the wings are taking longer. And so we've got a little issue with that, trying to work these. So partial orders went, but no wings have gone out with any of those orders.
You know, it's surprising to me. Every restaurant, when you put a plate out to be picked up, the ticket goes with it. So you see what table number, what time, you know exactly if you have everything, if there's four items on the ticket and there's only one, you wait to have the others. Not here.
Hey, we have three standing at the bar right now. Who's taking those tickets?
I don't know. There's no tickets. No, what are you doing?
I just threw a ticket right over there.
No, she's not dropping tickets. You guys don't know where they're going.
Oh, oh.
Dropping. Yeah, that's fine. I'm looking. I've got to bring them back over here.
Nine?
Not bad. What do we got going on in here? Oh, boy!
Oh, boy.
Valesky, you're being doubled in drink volume.
Usually I'm a lot faster than that and more accurate, and I just guess I couldn't handle it.
All right, give me the scoop. What do you guys think?
Okay. I was just talking to him about this. The teriyaki taste is good. I feel like they could have cooked this a little longer.
Can I bring this back with me? I want to show it to them. And I'll send you out one of those.
Okay.
We got raw chicken going out.
All right. Yes, sir. Sure are.
So that's going to be a problem. Ronnie, we got a problem.
I'm going to ask you to deal with it. Some wings came back raw. If there are any other wings out there, you don't want people eating them.
Oh, boy.
Everyone needs a little time to realize. Since this Maria switched to game fabric, hello, soft, Fancy Blue.
We're good, Ronnie. Everything's
fine. Oh, Fancy. So, soft. Hey, the number one scent available in softener.
I love you more.
Life is busy, and sometimes odors can shake up on you. For a convenient life hack, try Febreze Unstoppable Fabric Refresher. With 2 times the scent power of regular Febreze, Unstoppable Fabric finds, neutralizes, and eliminates tough odors trapped in hard-to-wash fabrics, like couches or smelly sports equipment, leaving an irresistibly fresh scent. And for a tropical burst of freshness, try new Paradise Scent. Stop sneaky odors from lingering in your home with Febreze Unstoppable.
One for me, and one for me. Introducing Buy One, Get One for just $1 at Burger King. Grab a flame-grilled Whopper or Impossible Whopper and mix and match it with your favorite for an extra buck. Go ahead. You deserve it. Buy One, Get One for $1. Your way, way better.
I'm ordering some burritos.
Oh, nice.
Burritos? Get a freshly made footlong from Subway instead, with crisp veggies on freshly baked bread. Just order in the app.
Huh, okay.
Try the other
one
with banana peppers for a squash or kick.
Kick. I get it.
Ooh. Get a custom-made footlong from Subway instead.
Choose better, be better. And now say when you order
from
Subway, eat fresh.
Bingo
for my face. I don't want shingles when I'm her age.
If you're 50 or older, you're at increased risk.
Well, that's life. Nothing you can do.
Well, shingles can be prevented.
Shingles can be what?
50 years or older, get vaccinated for shingles now.
Ronnie, we got a problem. I'm going to ask you to deal with it. Some wings came back raw. If there are any other wings out there, we don't want people eating them.
Raw chicken from the kitchen. Half orders going out to table. So half people get it, half people don't. A lot of the food is cold because it sits up there too long waiting for the rest of the food. Obviously, we didn't cook things completely, so we have big issues in the kitchen we need to resolve. Jared was strong behind the bar. Melissa was not. I've seen what I need to see. Now I need to close this place and go to work.
Folks, I thank everybody for coming. We've seen what we need to see tonight. We know what we need to work on. Right, I bet you guys can probably tell us what we need to work on, too. We're going to shut down so we can go to work remodeling this place.
Had a pleasure, Luella. Nice to meet you. I'm out.
Thank
pleasure,
you.
Sir.
Thank you.
Our bartenders were not particularly fast, and Melissa was totally inaccurate. So I'm eager to go back inside, have a staff meeting. I want to see exactly how much we wasted compared to how much we sold. I have a special surprise for the best employee of the night. I'm going to have them do something that nobody gets to do. Okay, so how many glasses of waste do we have over there?
We have 5, sir. Yeah, Jared's got 20, about 24, 25. Obviously not 25, 11.
And it shows a real difference, Jared. My hat's off, buddy. Well, I'm very close to MGM. And I set it up for you guys to go to the fountains. And Jared, since you impressed me so much, you're going to push the button that sends off the fountain.
Wow, that's an honor.
This would be a great way to energize us for a big day of training tomorrow.
Where's my gun, though?
Open. You guys ready?
Forehead.
Okay, let's dive in tomorrow. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you, gentlemen.
They all love it on day.
Jared, what's going on? Welcome to the Velocicon Show Control. I've heard that you actually won an amazing award. And as a thanks from everyone at the MGM Resort, we would like to let you press the hit button.
Sounds good.
Boom!
Really cool coming from New York to Vegas and being able to do something so iconic as pushing the button at the Bellagio Fountain.
Yeah, man!
I really have no words to describe how amazing this was today. I've always been a little baby of Cantina, and I still feel that way, but I'm honored to be here and step up to the plate with all of them. Never get old.
Run over for a second.
One of the things that really bothers me is the patio sort of hides the building,
so you don't have any brand visibility,
and it's not connected to the space.
Yeah.
We have all of this space here.
Oh, yeah.
Which could be funny. And then we could put some lights out here. The lighting back here will draw your eye back wherever we're connected.
Right.
You know, one of the issues I think we've got is this back area.
We have a whole new back door coming in.
No,
we got a
darker
section here.
We got further along as far as this used to be a darker zone of wood, too.
I'm an oasis packer shelf in the center. Keep this dark and cozy. We can bring that down.
Mm-hmm.
8 inches, 10 inches.
Yeah.
Can you hang some kind of light under it so it glows a little? I just want to make it dimmer back there.
Right.
A bottle set at each workstation.
Okay.
Great. Thanks, everybody.
What's up, guys?
He's doing
up,
right?
I am.
We're good.
So, last night was a little
crazy.
At today's training, what I want from these guys is learn consistency. Make sure you learn the recipes. Make sure you can actually pour the drink and just overall work as a team. So today we're going to be making mint Bahama Mama. John partnered up with Island Oasis. They've given us this machine to make these fresh ingredient cocktails and just overall make their lives easier.
So we're going to start off with our what first?
Your juices.
There we go.
So we're going to go with a half ounce of pina colada, quarter an ounce of grenadine, and now we're going to do 1 ounce of coconut puree.
Hey, how you doing, John?
How we doing?
Good.
So, we're going to do equal parts of coconut rum and regular rum. And then this goes inside the Island Oasis. Let me get my teeth brushed. Beautiful, clean, quick.
And you can make another drink while it's burning.
Exactly, and then we're going to top off with mint.
Look at that.
It's aromatic.
We're a party bar, guys. We can
thank you. Exactly.
Wow.
John showed up to our training day. It was really cool. It gave us all a shot of inspiration. Ronnie's our main leader, of course. He's the general, but John coming in really pepped up our step a bit. And it was really nice to see how much he actually cares about us, that he would show up to make sure our training was going good.
Assertive selling in a party bar is fun.
Here we go. Okay, who's getting shots here? 1, 2, 3. Come on, guys, 4 shots.
Assertive selling. Right, we're constantly looking at people. Who's shot time? Who's this?
And it's a show. John really emphasized that he didn't want to lose the actual character of the Cantina. He wants us all to maintain our smiles, maintain our party atmosphere. So him reiterating that felt good.
I want you guys to have fun with this. I just want to make sure that the smile doesn't disappear, guys. That we get back to pre-pandemic mode. Let's get back to that place.
Okay.
Keep going, thanks, bud.
I think it's awesome that John wants us to be the party bar in Las Vegas. For John to put his stamp of approval on that and that he wants us and backs us to do it means that we're more than capable of doing that.
All right, so guys, we have a lot of training that we need to get through, but I'm confident that you guys can do it because you guys are family, right? And that's what we want. We want people that care about their job. So we're just going to train to get to that spot. But make sure during launch we have everything that we need and we kill it. Yep.
Yeah.
All right, let's go.
All right, guys. Ron, look at you, buddy. You cleaned up pretty good, huh?
I go back to my old club days for you, buddy.
How you feeling?
80% excited, 20% terrified.
Do you trust me right now?
I do.
You know I care about you, right?
I actually
believe that, sir. I truly do.
I care about all you guys. I want to come through for you now. There's something special here. And you know what? Vegas is that way. We're tight as a community, aren't we?
Yes, sir.
And you guys emulate it. Did you see there's starting to be people on the strip? Yes. Have you guys noticed it the past week or 10 days? Is there a better time for you to remodel and reopen with new energy than really right now?
Signing clear purchase, brother. This is perfect.
There's only one thing left to do, is there?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Raise this.
Yeah.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. One. Two. Three.
These hands have seen rough times, and I've got some challenges to prove it. Growing up, my parents struggled. I was beaten by police at 15. So I became a police officer to battle racism from within. As Brooklyn Borough President, I worked around the clock to fight against COVID. I'm Eric Adams. I'll be a blue-collar mayor. I'll rebuild our economy while tackling violent crime and bring New York back. Paid for by Eric Adams, 2021.
I can't. Oh, shit.
No.
Or not?
No.
Want him?
Ooh, I like him.
Quick, the quicker picker-upper. Bounty picks up messes quicker. And each sheet is 2 times more important, so you can use less.
He's an 8.
He's a 9.
Bounty, the quicker picker-upper.
My doctor requires no insurance.
No copay.
And I get to see her as many times as I want.
One flat fee, no surprise bills, no copays, $149 a month. Board membership includes unlimited doctor's visits because our goal is to keep you healthy and not to bill you for services when you get sick. Get better health care for less. Learn more about Ford's all-inclusive health care at goforward.com.
$2
pairs of shoes for
$9.95
plus free shipping. Only at FastKids.com.
One, two, three.
Are you proud right now? No, I'm feeling proud, man. You should be. You went through hell to get here, man.
Hart Lauer Signs, a great Las Vegas company, worked all night long to get that sign that's done for you. And graphics done inside. Hey, ready for this?
Yeah.
All right, go ahead, guys.
Good. There we go. That's a
good one. Try some of it.
Somewhere at the beach.
Oh my god.
It's incredible. Look
at
how clean all this is.
Look, okay.
Oh my god, it's dancing. It's so clean. I love staples. Please, it's a thing that makes me so happy. The color and the tables are beautiful. Everything is just top notch.
Still has the personality of the old bar, right?
Yeah.
But everything is clean. We did the wood to warm it up a little. It's too cold in here with the diamond plate. Video content is provided by Atmosphere TV, and I got your free subscription to that. So I got standard restaurant supplies to give you 2 kegerators to drift here. I got Crown to give you guys these very special soda gun holsters. The soda gun jetter system cleans the soda gun every night automatically.
Wow.
I also got big-ass fans.
What a company,
critical. So we had to do that for you just from a sanitary standpoint to keep the room safer. Blue Zone is a Middleby company. It removes all airborne bacteria from the air.
This is the safest place to get drunk in Vegas.
It is. Then we got the pass spot for you. And with pass spot, you wash your hands. You put your hands underneath it. And if you get a green light, There's no bacterial or viral matter on your hands. You go to work. If you get a red light, you got to wash them again.
No COVID.
And we have a free subscription to Partender. You can do inventory in one well. In minutes, we have two Harbor Touch POS machines. You'd have to hit a cop key now, won't you?
Yeah.
So I wanted to make certain we were set up to speed, set up for clean, and set up for accuracy. This is an important bar in this city. Employees come here. When we make them happy, they make our visitors happy, and our city works. And that's the responsibility you guys have. Tonight's the beginning of getting everything back that was taken from you this year. So this is for him. So let's all make each other proud tonight, okay? All right, you got a bar to open. Let's go, guys. Let's set it up. Let's do it. Welcome to Paradise Cantina! Come on in, guys! Come on! Come on! Welcome to Paradise Cantina, guys! Come on in! Come on in!
See you guys?
Nice to do a spoken out bit. Mama, mama, and then some food.
I feel absolutely enthralled that my boy Ron is happy.
Oh, that's just a perfect boy, Jared.
I knew that he was going through it a little bit, but seeing him tonight, that actual shine is back.
You're bubbling.
So here comes all the tickets.
Just like we did on training.
Oh, we got a head start. I like that. That's what's up.
All right, we'll get the rest of that out for you. So welcome.
It's been a brutal year for everybody in this industry, and seems like there's a little light at the end of the tunnel finally, and it's makes it a little bit brighter. And you can't see it under the mask, but they're all smiling. I can tell in their eyes, so.
And I'm happy.
I love Paradise
Cantina! Yeah!
Yeah! Wow. When I met you 4 days ago, I looked in the eyes and said I was going to take care of you. And I was going to come through for you. And that meant a lot to me to do so. Did I? I hope you gave you the tools now, and you've got every opportunity to succeed.
Absolutely.
For sure.
Claudia, listen, a couple months, next year, we'll be playing on the back. I can't wait, all right?
All right.
Bye, guys.
This one means a lot. This bar serves all the employees who take care of all the visitors that make Las Vegas what it is.
There are 650,000 people in Las Vegas, and nearly a third of them work in hospitality. As important as the tourists are to this city, the locals matter just as much. Paradise Cantina is a place where the essential workers of the city come for some hospitality, and I can't think of a better reason to help rescue a bar that provides just that.
For more cool consideration provided by Harbor Touch, Fast Bar, Atmosphere TV, Partender, Crown, Big Ass.
Another episode, baby boy.
These don't belong with those other tampons. Because with Tampax Radiant, you get more. A lot more. This week's offering helps you have more this week, period. This texture grip is designed for more comfortable insertion. And there are a lot of words that describe this clean fill wrapper. Made for more ease, more clean, more hygiene. Get more with Tampax Radiant, also in light absorbency.
For 20 years I've been open.
Yeah.
Well, I want you doing clowns. You think? What do you think? I'm not a clown.
For over 30 years, John Tapper has traveled the country, saving hundreds of bars from failure and ruin. And he thought he'd seen it all. until the COVID-19 pandemic hit.
Look, I've met terrible owners, unruly staffs, out-of-control financing, but I've never seen anything like this.
And no business was hit harder than America's hospitality industry.
Thousands of bars have closed already, and more are going to close. America is built on small businesses, and I want to fight to keep as many bars open as I possibly can.
So now, John's not only rescuing struggling businesses, he's trying to save an entire industry, one bar at a time.
Failure is not an option. No excuses.
So this season, John's starting with the hospitality capital of the world and the place he calls home, Las Vegas.
This is now personal to me. I cannot let them down.
In 2002, Chicago native Nico Santucci moved to Las Vegas and opened Capo's Restaurant and Speakeasy.
I grew up in Chicago in the restaurant business. My father, my uncle, we had a pizzeria, Santucci's, and it was something that was always a big place in my heart. But I had dreams bigger than could be imagined in Chicago, so I came west and built Capo's.
Capo's quickly became a legendary spot and a pillar of the Las Vegas nightlife.
What's the best one? Capo's is a gangster genre restaurant in front of speakeasy.
It's dark, it's romantic, it's mysterious. Only server, we got three on tonight.
My brother Dominic runs the joint, and as a family, we created, I feel, a very cohesive unit.
With its unique speakeasy concept and passionate brothers at the helm, Capo's flourished as one of the most successful restaurants off the strip for 2 decades.
Always.
When we opened Capo's, it was huge. For 15 years, we were doing upwards of $5 million a year.
Capo's was one of the busiest restaurants in Las Vegas. We used to do 300 to 400 covers a night.
We used to have 4 bartenders behind the bar, and it was basically from the moment from when you walk in until you walk out.
For 20 years, Capo's continued to boast growing profits. But when the COVID-19 pandemic struck, Capo's was forced to close its doors.
When COVID struck us, we lost $1 million in no time. I thought it was the end.
After being shut down for 6 months, Capo's was allowed to reopen with strict health guidelines and at a reduced capacity.
Because of COVID, I had to cut back the staff. The bills don't stop.
When we first shut down, Nico gathered all his employees together and offered to help us out with severance or whatever he could do for us. But we thought it was a better idea to keep the money to reopen Capo's. We wanted him to keep Capo's going.
As the ongoing pandemic continued to strain his business, Nico was dealt more hard blows.
My mom passed away while we were closed. And 7 days after my mom passed, I had major throat surgery. I had a tumor in my throat I'm still recovering from. It has been certainly the worst year of my life, along with many others.
Without their trusted leader at the helm, the staff at Capo struggled to navigate the new challenges facing the bar.
It would be very devastating if they were shrunk. If I were taken home here, everybody's been here for many years. We all like family.
You know, you gotta flip this around, man. This can't continue. Like, all right, when the light at the end of the tunnel will be there, but...
This is more like a legacy. The Santucci legacy will be. And it would be pretty sad if it was shrunk.
So before Capo has become another COVID casualty, Nico has agreed to pull back the doors, bust open the bolts, to make a call for help. The bar rescue.
And without John, my entire staff might lose what we've done for 20 years.
Did you know that your toughest cleaning problems can be caused by hard water metals? They lock in residues like a glue, and your hard surfaces in fabric. Try 9 Elements. It's vinegar-powered deep clean, dissolves hard water buildup, and releases trapped residues and odors, like detoxifying your clothes.
I love you more.
Never more than 9 ingredients. 9 Elements. More than a clean, cleanse.
Two and a half
Batman is shaking things up.
Do you realize what this means?
By moving to happy hour.
Three, expert Charlie, is this too early to start drinking?
2.5 Men, weekdays at 4 on Paramount Network.
New Dove Men plant-based body wash is different. With plant-based cleansers and moisturizers for healthy and hydrated men's skin. Relax your body and mind. Shower with New Dove Men.
A lot of folks ask me how to get their dishes as clean as possible. I tell them, try Cascade Platinum, plus the power of Oxy. It breaks down food soils to clean up to 99% of visible and invisible food residue for a hygienic clean you can see and feel. Cascade, plus the power of Oxy.
Moment of truth. The dishes are clean, but aren't they dry?
Yeah, they are. Thanks to Cascade Power Dry Rinse Aid from the number one most trusted brand. Get your dishes clean, dry, done. With Cascade Detergent plus Power Dry.
You want to see them call me back?
Engaged, but not sure what to do next? Plan your whole wedding at Zola. Start with venues and vendors near you. We'll find ones that fit your style and budget. Then it's tour save the date. Enjoy free personalized samples and free change the dates just in case. Add a free matching website to keep guests updated. You can even host virtual events on it for free. Build a registry that lives on your website too. Fill it with gifts, experiences, even cash fun. Start saving from home at Zola.com.
Wait, I'll wait for you. I love you. I love you. Keep on getting that, okay? I'll wait for you. I'm gonna write down too. Sorry for that, no, you're fine. For not, communicating, talking here, guys. But, quite a good Pokemon here, and finally found my Sunstone, so I bought my heal, I'll top the healer list, and my, probably the Abominus of Greninja. And now we're gonna be continuing on. Playing that. That's one of my life. That's the other one, sneaking by behind the bus there. So part of Meganium, which is my favorite Pokemon all the time, which we caught. It's very nice. And so we got a Frog to Greninja, and now we're about to take on the trial here. So we got the, which we gotta grab his Let's try to bug and into it. There we go. Let's go into the back into the observatory. Okay, good. Different than Ultra Moon, because Moon you just have to figure out what sounds are playing, but this one you have to move charging buttons to a line. Like it's like a puzzle. Makes it more interesting though, which is pretty cool.
I live in Washington,
for like 11 years.
See, I got to a line here, so we have it for 3 times. Got started. There we go. One. The first response normally will be an electric, but it's gonna be randomized. That's what the Alec is gonna be. It's gonna be an Alec of Dam. Not Mega though, which is pretty cool. I'll take it. How's it gonna come out? We're gonna send out, I don't like to send out Hester. Cause Frogger doesn't have a ground, a dark type move just yet. We're here with a 20, the Psycho Crush not gonna do much. Yeah, one turn the thing. Very good. Alright, number 2. There we go. Tell me why I got that one. Not sure we know that's the buzz. We'll be randomizing like the buzz, of course. We got here. Whoa, Mega Glalie. It's one of my favorite Mega Pokemon. I go to Manage, but I can go to Medi too. Never mind, he's close to lava. We're hitting with a lava plum. I sense to not do much. But we're here just to be safe. And I'll play Battle Mage to get burned. Turn on Ice Fang. Take burn damage. And we're headed with a lava plume. Has a 40?
Hindi na tatawa pa sa'yo. Holy crap! Kabahin na
Okay. Okay, let me just switch over the team just a little bit here before we continue. Enjoy the game. Okay, Madison's going on spot. There we go. Now this is someone that's telling them all, can we randomize a port? What did he say? This is a call to call tomorrow. Call tomorrow.
This is so bad.
That's what the total of the miles is going to be. It's gonna be a mega beat drill. Oh, I have my Magnus Morphin as well. It's gonna raise the speed, which is the highest stat. I'm gonna hit a little out of them. Charge is fine. Not burn. Let's see if this Lapple knocks it out. Yep, knocks it out. Very easy to pull in battle deck. And Matt's level 41. Right there. Good job, Magnus. So now we got the Electrium Z, now we can use the Google Ball Havoc Z move.
I'm going to go to the house.
Okay, cool. We're going to press the Kui's mask, the Mask Royal's mask. Alright, so we're in the video mania. Thank you guys for watching part 7. To do part 8, we'll be heading towards the next trial, so which I believe is 2D Mega Man with Ace and Rolla. Or you can check out on 6 trials, try to complete that one. If you guys like the video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe for videos like this, and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on a video. Stay tuned for more videos, man. Bye for now.